one where I tried plumes and beads and fabrics, all kinds of things. See how they work. It's hard watching you cut that.
Why is it?
Is it $1 million bill or a 100,000? The model needs more. Not
tight. And them either.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, that color is really popping. Another acrylic paint, I think. It's slick.
What do you want next?
We got this big one right here. Ooh. This is a huge experimental piece right here. It's got the rose gold and silver, the other one has the gold. A lot sticking out.
Yep. Somebody predicted that. Who knows that?
Maybe we like push it down in it somehow? I don't know.
I don't know if that'll work. This is going to stick to that unless you put something underneath it.
It's not bad if it does and it gives it a base instead of foam board. Right. Maybe do this one. Like that sample one, we can cut around it, and then if it sticks where it's more straight, so it got curved up. This fabric should be fully in it. Yeah.
Okay, we're not going to pour those two tonight.
Lazy Susan's looking great. Curious on that washi tape. Oh, look, that fabric piece looks good. And we're done?
No.
Oh. What about this thing? All these pieces are sticking out still.
Yep.
What kind of gun is that, or flame gun?
Propane torch.
Just a propane torch? Regular?
Yep.
So, do you think some of these might need more than one pour?
Well, you can't have this rough stuff on there. That was what the problem is.
Well, I had wondered if when you poured the epoxy on it,
and this has got stuff, this has got like beads or something in it.
Maybe beads.
Right in there, like on her nose, that's a bead of some sort. There, I got it.
Maybe it's from the gold leaf flakes.
Yeah.
But I had thought if you put the epoxy on here, it would just weigh it down and flatten it.
No, those are too thin to do that. That's what I was talking about.
Let me see this level here.
Oh, shit.
What's wrong?
That's a tool that I didn't want to put epoxy on.
What if we put tape?